Hello.
Good evening, everybody.
Yeah, welcome to the Trumansburg Conservatory of Fine Arts and a little music with Drank the Gold. This is James. I'm Oona. We play some instruments. Sometimes we sing. And we're going to do a little music.
Yeah, this is one we wrote called Gourd Season. Gourd Season.
We thought it's seasonally appropriate.
Gourd Season, yes.
Yeah. Ourselves here, but we can imagine you out there clapping and dancing, maybe cheering, all that. So we're just imagining you out there. It's so fun. This is such a beautiful hall, and it sounds so pretty in here. And I just it's a treat to be playing in a room like this, I have to say. And it's a treat to be playing music at all and to be performing in one way or the other.
Indeed. What should we play now? Pretty Sarah. A lot of folks know this one, Pretty Sarah. We got turned on to a bunch of different versions by Mark Simos at a music camp that we went to. Boy, was that a lot of fun. One of the versions he showed us was something by Mac Trainum, great banjo player, and we were really inspired by his version in particular on this, but we tried to make it our own. So we'll do a little pre-sero.
Well, I left my little darling, and I quit my mother too. And I started up to ramble this country all through. And every night when I get tired, I sit down and weep. And I dream. Pretty Well, it's not this long a journey I'm dreading to go. It's not for my country or debts that I owe. There's just one thing that grieves me and troubles my mind, and that's a leaving British Sarah, my darling, behind.
Sounds really good in here. I hope this awesome microphone is capturing some of the ambiance and everyone can hear us really good, but also if you can feel like you're in this space, yeah, I hope you can.
Yeah. Well, maybe as the evening progresses, we'll give you little snapshots from the room. I have a really beautiful view across the way here of a gorgeous quilt that's hanging on the wall, and it's lighted really nicely. And yeah, I hear it's part of an auction that you could find more info about it on the Trumansburg Conservatory of Fine Arts website, which we memorized this. It's the
tbergconservatory.org.
Yeah.
Yes, there's a lot of really interesting artwork here that's part of
maybe we'll part of the rent. As we go along, maybe we should
describe each piece.
You didn't know you were coming for an art description.
It's a virtual evening. Art tour. We just describe it.
We promise. We'll play you some more music here. I think we're going to sing another song here. And you want to introduce this one, James?
This is a Woody Guthrie song that I learned from an old YouTube video of, when somebody puts on the record and they're spinning the record and they film the record and you can listen to it
on YouTube. Video record archives.
Yeah. So I learned it from a record, but I watched the record on YouTube. And funny enough, I'm glad I learned the version when I did, because that version has disappeared.
Ooh, ooh.
Somebody took it down.
So you better listen to us play it in order to get our interpretation.
The rare YouTube version of this song. We're on YouTube right now. All right.
Oh, just do a little strum. I was so excited to play this show because I haven't played a show in a little while that I changed all my strings on this fiddle. And
twice.
Just once lately, but they sound really, really good. but they're also maybe going to stretch out a little bit, so we might have to tune a couple times. But let's get on with the song. One, two, three.
Lots of folks back east, they say, leaving home every day, beat the old hot dusty way to the California line. Across the desert sand they roll to get out of the old dust bowl, think they're going to the sugar bowl, but here's what they find. That the police at the port of entry say, you're number 14,000 for today. If you ain't got the do-re-mi, folks, you ain't got the do-re-mi, better head back to beautiful Texas, Oklahoma, Kansas, Georgia, Tennessee. California's a garden of Eden, a paradise to live in or see. Believe it or not, you won't find it too hot if you ain't got the do-re-mi. Nobody harm or take your vacations by the mountains or sea. But don't swap your old cow for a car. You'd better stay right where you are. You'd better take this little tip from me. 'Cause I look through the want ads every day, but the headlines in the paper always say,
if you ain't got that do-re-mi,
folks,
you ain't got that do-re-mi,
better head back to beautiful Texas, Oklahoma, Kansas, Georgia, Tennessee. California's a garden of Eden, a paradise to live in or see. Believe it or not, you won't find it too hot if you ain't got that do-re-mi.
That last note sounded really good in here. Da-da-da-da-da. Echo, echo.
Yeah. Yeah. Playing in a hall. All right. Well, we hope you're having fun. We're having fun. And let's see. James is going to pick up the guitar and we're going to play a couple Irish tunes. Oh, no. I'm not reading the list correctly. I'm jumping ahead. Forget I said that.
Yeah, first we're going to do a little Carter Family song.
I'm going to put my bow down and play pretend ukulele. Since I don't know how to play ukulele, I'll play fiddle-lele.
Fiddle-lele.
I kissed my love beneath the walnut tree over the garden wall. She whispered and said she'd be true to me over the garden wall. She had beautiful lips and beautiful hair, She wasn't so tall, so she stood on a chair. And many a time I kissed her there over the garden wall. Over the garden wall, the sweetest love of all. There never were yet such eyes of jet, and you can bet I'll never forget the night our lips in kisses met over the garden. There's always a night and there's always a day over the garden wall. There's always a will and there's always a way over the garden wall. We hadn't much money, but the weddings were cheap. So while her old fella was snoring asleep, with a lamp and a ladder, she managed to creep over the garden wall. Over the garden wall, the sweetest love of all. There never were yet such eyes of jet, and you can bet I'll never forget the night our lips in kisses met over the garden wall. Over the garden wall, the sweetest love of all. There never were yet such eyes of jet, and you can bet I'll never forget the night our lips in kisses met over the garden wall.
Yeah, very nice.
Oh, I love singing that song. It's been a little while since we did that one, but I love it so much. But we're going to play a couple tunes, all tunes from Ireland. But we thought, since we have limited time, we'll take you on a little tour of all the different, a couple of the different dance tune types, because there are so many great types of dance tunes in Irish music. We'll give you a little sample pack here. So we'll start out with a hop jig, then we'll go to a double jig, a normal jig, and we'll finish with the polka.
Sounds good.
Yeah. Well, Tune type tour. Let's see. Get my tapping foot set. I'll try not to tap too loud in the microphone, but just send a message if I should pipe down with my tapping foot. All right.
Thank you.
Before we played those tunes, but I wanted to dedicate them to my cousins, the Grady girls. When we first started talking about doing this show here, we were trying to see if it would be possible to do it with all of them as well, seeing as most of them are based here in Ithaca, and James and I, when we come here to visit from Saratoga Springs, which is where we live, we love to play music with them, of course. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, just because of all the business of the times, it didn't quite work out to all be trying to play and sing music right here on the stage. But we look forward to a time in the future, soon, we hope, that we get to do another show with them, or at least sit around in the kitchen and play a couple tunes. So all that said, we got a little song here.
Yeah, so we haven't been performing a lot because of the circumstances. But one cool thing we've been doing is in the town we live in, Saratoga Springs, there's this great old folk venue called Cafe Lena. And they're kind of expanding their operations into having a music school. And part of that is a music school for kids 7 to 12. So Oona and I have been teaching there.
Yeah,
Oona's been teaching fiddle.
Getting to help them get it. Off the ground, really. It's been a great project. Good quarantine project.
Yeah,
really.
Yeah. We're all doing these Zoom groups with the kids online, and they seem to really like it. We're showing them a lot of classic folk music, and so
we're reminding ourselves of some of those tunes.
What do you start people out with? So we've discovered some old chestnuts that are like, yeah. I think we're gonna start playing that.
I don't. You don't mind if I do.
So here's one of them. You'll definitely recognize this.
Sing along at home if you like.
In a cavern, in a canyon, excavating for a mine, lived a miner 49. His darling Clementine. Oh, my darling, oh, my darling, oh, my darling Clementine. You are lost and gone forever, dreadful sorry Clementine. Light she was and like a fairy, her shoes were number 5, herring boxes without tops, sandals were for Clementine. Oh, my darling, oh, my darling, oh, my darling Clementine, you are lost and gone forever, dreadful sorry Clementine.
drove she ducks to the water every morning just at dawn. Hit her foot against a splinter, fell into the foaming brine. Oh, my darling, oh, my darling, oh, my darling Clementine, you are lost and gone forever, dreadful sorry Clementine. Ruby lips above the water, blowing bubbles soft and fine. But alas, I was no swimmer, so I lost my Clementine. Oh, my darling, oh, my darling, oh, my darling Clementine. You are lost and gone forever, dreadful sorry Clementine. Oh, my darling. Oh, my darling, oh, my darling Clementine. You are lost and gone forever, dreadful sorry Clementine. Oh, my darling, oh, my darling.
That's not the version we show the kids, but that's our version. Hope you like it.
All right. We're going to cheer things up a little bit. Try to at least. This is a song we've been playing with for quite a while. We were playing a more Irish-y version at first. James had been singing it for a long time, I think.
Yep. Yep, I love this song. This is Raglan Road, the Dawning of the Day.
Yeah.
It's one of the first tunes we put together.
Yeah. So it's evolved along the way. I think, did we record this one on the album?
I think we did.
I think we did. Yeah, the banjo version.
Yeah. We made a recording last year at Electric Wilburland.
Yeah, down the a couple streets.
That was
here.
A lot of fun.
It sure was. Can't wait to get back there.
So you can find that version on our website, drinkthegold.com. If you want to check out the different versions of tunes we put on there.
We got that CD for sale and a couple other pieces of merchandise if you're looking for maybe some holiday gifts or, you know, Halloween celebratory things.
Mm-hmm. So this version was kind of inspired by the fan on the
that's right.
The patio of the Muzan House, which is a restaurant and a place that we used to play a lot in Saratoga.
Every Monday for years.
And when it was hot, the fan would be on, and the fan was very much in the key of G. So one day we just decided to go for it. We'll play them all in G.
3 hours in
three hours of G. And that's how this arrangement was born. This is Raglan Road.
Oh. Like I said, let me just double check my tuning. We just had whole talk about how it's in G, and I picked up I didn't pick up the correct fiddle. I kept holding the other fiddle because we used to play it in D.
How's that one sound?
Much better. Haven't been doing this performing thing lately. Bear with us. 1, 2, 3.
Out on the rag and road. On an autumn day I saw her first dance. That her dark hair would weave a snare that I might one day rue. I saw the danger, yet I walked along the enchanted way. And I sailed at grief, the falling leaf at the dawning of the day. On Grafton Street, in November, we tripped lightly along the ledge of a deep ravine where can be seen the worth of passion's pledge. But the queen of hearts is still baking tarts. I'm not baking hay. And love too much by such, not such is happiness thrown away. Gifts of the mind, oh, I gave her that secret sign that's known to all the artists of sound and stone and time. Oh, with words and tin, I never did stint. Gave her reams of poems to say of our own dark hair, their own name there like some clouds over fields of May. On a quiet street, world ghosts meet, I'd see her walking there. All away from me so hurriedly, my reason must allow that I would not as I should, a creature made of clay. When the angel moves the clay, he'd lose his wings at dawn of the day.
I'm still enjoying this quilt.
Well, we've got some nice sculptures. They're all like wall hanging sculptures. We got ceramics. There's looks like some lithographs, some prints, all kinds of artwork around here. I guess the conservatory is open on Friday and Saturday. Come check the stuff out.
Come check it out. We might have to do a little wander when we finish with this little stream here. Just see what all they have. I think we're gonna play another tune by James.
Yeah. This is a tune. I was trying to write a reel on the banjo. Didn't really work out so well, but
it didn't turn really into.
It didn't really work out. But I don't know. It's kind of neat. We did this one with our friend Daniel Enblum. Who we have a trio with called Step Tune.
Yeah.
And actually the last time that we performed in Ithaca, I think was with Step Tune in
March. Back in March. It was like yeah. the that was kind of the last hurrah. We didn't know it at the time, but it was a good party out at South Hill Cider. Our friend Steve Seelen hosted us, and we had a grand time in early March. Danielle stepped some steps to this tune.
Yeah. So you'll just have to imagine the dancing for this.
Maybe you could make up your own dance.
It's a little crooked, so
beware.
Make sure there's nothing close by. All right, the Irish import. This isn't it. It's a really weird reel.
Stop with us.
Hopefully
all right, dance out good job dancing out there. And let's see, we're gonna do a little song. You could try singing along if you know the jute mill song. This is a song that we've sung a lot with Leah, my cousin. I feel like that's kind of through Leah singing it is how you got introduced to it.
Yep.
I learned
Leah's version.
James learned Leah's version. I think Leah, we can interview her later, but I think she learned it from the singing of Karen Casey. That's where I was first heard it. And it's a good old song. Yeah, anything else you want to say about it?
Just jump, I don't think so.
Jump in?
Let's jump right in.
Fast and the polling shifters can't get their rest. Shifting bobbins, coarse and fine, bear the big bluework for your 10 and 9. Thank you. wish the day was done. Running up and down the past is no fun. Shifting, piecing, spinning, warp, weft, and twine. Feed and clothe your bonds off of 10 and 9. World is ill divided. Them that works the hardest are the least provided. I'm home by contented. Dark days are fine. There's not much pleasure working off of 10 and 9. Runs fast, and the poor wee shifters can't get their rest. Shifting, piecing, spinning, warp, weft, and twine. Feed and clothe your bonds off of 10 and 9.
All right. Thank you, thank you. So, let's see, what else do I have written down here? Maybe we'll do a jig?
Yeah. Another one of the projects that we've been missing playing with is something, well, it has a strange name. We need to come up with a better name for it. It's called folk song.
it's a little unspecific.
not very useful when you're Googling it, but...
Yeah, it's really bad for the search engine.
our friend Galen Passon, who's a sitar player, who lives in New York City now, he had this notion to combine some Indian classical music with Irish tunes.
And make a big musical project out of that. Do a lot of, pulling from both those traditions and sort of music worlds, but also from that collision, I suppose, trying to invent something completely new.
Yeah.
So much fun. Completely learned a lot. Still have so much more to learn.
Yeah.
as far as Indian music has to go. But James got inspired.
Yeah, I got inspired. I wrote this Galen showed us this raga, and tried to use the notes from that to make a jig. So we'll see. You know, it's funny, I think Galen was inspired to start that project because he was working with a percussive dancer, and I guess she had some connection to Irish music and dance as well. But it turns out lots of other people have done this Irish-Indian fusion.
So there must be something to it.
It's in the air.
Yeah, well, this tune, James calls it Flying Swan, after, I guess that's one translation of the name of the raga. All the vibrations are working together.
Hopefully.
Ready, go.
Nice. Sounds good in here.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a good one. I think that swan is up flying in the the back over in the balcony. There's this beautiful blue sky with golden stars that I'm enjoying looking out at. To give you a little more shape your vision of this room. Yeah, let's see. Should we sing a song here?
Well, I mentioned earlier that Oona and I are doing the Cafe Lena School of Music for the kids ages 7 to 12. And, you know, at some point, you know, when I'm showing them guitar, I'll show them minor chords. And what is the quintessential minor chord song? And well, we couldn't decide, of course, because there's just so many. But one of them was this one, Wayfaring Stranger. I'm a poor wayfaring stranger, traveling through this world below. There is no sickness, no toll, no danger, in that bright land to which I go. I'm going there to see my father and all my loved ones who've gone on. I'm just going over Jordan. I'm just going over home. Dark clouds may gather round me. I know my way is dark and steep, but beauteous fields arise before me, where God's redeemed their vigils keep. I'm going there to see my mother. She said she'd meet me when I come. So I'm going over Jordan. I'm just going over home. I'm just going over Jordan. I'm just going. Yeah.
That's a good minor chord song.
Sure is. Well, I think we have time for one more.
Oh, thank you. All right. So, very important question. How can people tip us? We love to play music. You don't have to, but we totally appreciate if you would love to give us a tip. You can go to our website, drankthegold.com. And there is a place to do that right on the front page, a little digital tip jar, or it's called something like that. You'll be able to find it once you get there. And yeah, and like we said earlier, if you'd like to get something in exchange for your tip, we do have CDs and t-shirts and I think some art prints and I can't remember what else. Probably some other good stuff that you could also buy, and we'll send you some goodies. And or you could get a digital download if you don't want any more things to stack in your house. We're all hunkering down for the winter, trying not to pack our houses too full of things so we have some space. Let's see, we're getting low on time here. What do you think? I want to play
those jigs,
those tunes
to close it out.
Yeah, maybe we'll see what happens there.
Yeah.
Is there anything else? Well, we really want to thank the Conservatory and Mark for having us.
Thank you.
It's a treat to play in this room. It's a treat to have a gig, and it's a treat to have an excuse to play some music for all of you guys out there on the internet land. And thanks. Yeah, just a lot of thanks.
Yeah, thanks for listening.
These we're gonna finish, I think, with a set of some Irish tunes that I put them together a couple days ago, and a couple versions of The Maid on the Green, and then a version of Leg of the Duck. It's a little bit different than the way I normally play it. But I wanted to dedicate it to, I guess, all the people who have taught us music and helped us out along the way, but especially to Ed McGowan, who was my first fiddle teacher. And yeah. Oh, let's do a little quick.
Thank you.
right.
Thanks, everybody.
Thanks
Get
for
home
listening.
Safe.
Enjoy your evening.
Have a great night.